Welcome back to Ebony Maria. My name is Elp. So glad to have y'all here. Y'all, happy Monday. I just dropped the kiddos off. I'm coming home to get my steps together. Today is the office day. And in the morning time, it's such a struggle with my son that, I have to come back and get myself ready. So I'm about to get myself together, do my skincare routine, just all my usuals. Get my daily devotion in, just everything I need before I head to the office to have a good day. But I want to come in, check in, start the week out right, and tell y'all happy Monday. And be sure y'all come in, like, and subscribe and share so y'all can, we can have some people join our party, y'all. And I'll be back later. Peace. Hey, y'all. Welcome back. I just made it to the office, y'all. I definitely found me a new way to do my coffee, and I'm gonna go to the grocery store when I leave work today to get us something to eat for dinner, and I'm gonna buy the things that I need to try to make it, because I found it on TikTok because I said to myself, I knew that was one of my biggest things with my weight loss, is because I do love coffee. I love coffee. I don't use just extremely sugar, but I do use flavored creamer. And if we know, some of those can be sugary, some of those can be dairy, some of those, and I haven't quite found the ones that I like that were non-dairy yet, but I also could have not searched for them. So I'm gonna look for that. I'm gonna look for non-dairy creamer that's got flavor, and I'm gonna look for the, so basically, I tried to do it today, but Racetrack didn't have any protein shakes in the cold thing. They only had the one by Fairy Life or something like that, but they were just too expensive for one little bottle, and I was like, nah, I'm not doing that. So, but I did just make it to work. I gotta go in here, and while I'm in here, I'm gonna get on Amazon, y'all, because I need me one of the things to prop my camera on that hold on, like a tripod for your car, and I need a new small one, because y'all, that big stick, I ain't gonna lie, it's coming handy when it's time to rotate, like set up a stand. But baby, when I say I do get a little embarrassed when I be out and about trying to vlog, and I'm like, I got this huge stick, like I'm gonna whoop somebody, like I'm the police or somebody. So I'm about to get on here and find me a small little handle thing too, y'all, because I'm just like, this is embarrassing. This cannot reach. This is embarrassing. So, but I'm about to go in here for a few hours, and I'll be back when I leave work, and then I bring y'all to the store and see if y'all can find the stuff I need for my new coffee to help me continue to lose weight and not put in so much sugar in my body. Okay, so I'll be back. Good morning. Welcome back to Ebony Maria. My name is Elp. Happy Tuesday, y'all. I left my tripod in my husband's truck again from over the weekend. Yeah. So now I have to hold my camera. Yeah, so ghetto. Just so ghetto. But I just ordered me another one off of Amazon so I can have two. So the one, I've ordered me a small one because that's what I wanted to travel with. Like when we do go to date night stuff, I'm going to be, have that big old thing. I got a small one, and then I'm going to leave the big one in the house. So when I do stuff like this, my cleaning videos, whatever. But don't even mind it. We just know we be leaving it, okay? I'm doing better. I'm trying to make the camera get up that I'm getting, ordering the stage. We're doing what I need to do, because baby, between this battery keep dying and between me just scuffing up my thing, I'm buying me a little case to go around it, all the essentials, because baby, it's been through some things. But I am here to show y'all, I am about to try the new protein coffee. So if you guys was watching earlier this week, I told y'all that I got into size 14 and I am starting my weight loss journey. I'm losing weight, but I'm also trying to cut back, and I don't eat that much during the day, which is also a downfall, whatever, because my body be holding on to whatever it can. But also, I gotta stop with I am a coffee lover. Yeah, I'm a coffee addict. Ain't no coffee lover. I'm a coffee addict. Like, I'm addicted to coffees. But I don't use regular sugar. Like I told you, I always just use flavored creamer. However, we know creamer be having a lot of calories too. So I found this new idea. My boss told me about it. Actually, my boss's boss told me about it. She was like, when she lost, because she used to be a heavy lady, and she's like this now. And she was like, she started doing protein shakes as her creamer. So basically to be like breakfast and lunch, you know, to keep her full. It's a protein shake. And then with the black coffee. So I'm excited. Now, I did get Premier brand because these, I like Premier shakes. If even when I'm doing my regular weight loss without coffee, I like Premier. Now, I normally buy the chocolate ones, but being I always buy caramel macchiato creamer with caramel drizzle, I said I was going to try the caramel kind. So we can see. And then if I don't like it, I am going to try this new Oatly creamer, which is supposed to be no dairy, no gluten, no nuts, and basically a healthier option. And I got it in caramel too. So I'm going to see how just the black coffee and the protein shake works. And if it's nasty or this not sweet enough for my black coffee, I'm going to add a little creamer, a little of the Oatly creamer. Because at least, like I said, this is only 30 calories. Literally 30 calories, only 1 gram of fat. No saturated fat, no trans fat, no cholesterol, only 5 milligrams of sodium, 4 grams of carbohydrate, and only 4 grams of sugar. So, and calcium 2%. So this is way better. Do I still have my other one or was I out? I was out, but I probably could look it up. Let me see. Hold on. Okay, so I looked it up. So the caramel macchiato, original creamer that I do buy, it's actually only 35 calories, 2% fat, 3% saturated fat, no cholesterol, 2% carbohydrate, but it does have 5 milligrams or 10% added sugars, which is a little more than this, but it also is made from dairy, like it has 2%. Oh, they say it's contained 2% less of sodium, a milk derivative, or whatever. So it does have dairy. It's not non-dairy. Yeah, it contains milk. So even if I do continue to use it, okay, so my coffee actually was not that bad because, like I said, I use natural black dark roast coffee, which is coffee that has no calories, no nothing. It's plain. But I was only adding this, so that's actually not bad, but the dairy probably could be still an issue, especially like I said, with me having stomach issues lately. This is non-dairy, so we'll try this one. And like I said, it saves 5 calories and it saves sugar, so we'll see. But I'm actually just gonna try my protein shakes and see, because now the protein shakes, they do have calories, but it is also still a protein shake. Like, and the sugars is literally one gram. No, 0% added sugars. 20 milligrams of cholesterol, 300 milligrams of sodium, 3 grams of fat. But like I said, it's a protein shake. So it's going to help me with, it's going to basically kind of fill my stomach up alongside so I can eat. You know, so if that makes sense. So I'm not just not eating all day. At least I'm having some type of food, because I'm having like a meal shake. So yeah, so I'm about to make it and we're about to see and we're gonna test it out. I'll be back.
Focus.
Okay, so y'all, I tried the protein mix with coffee. It's not as sweet. However, we're not going to give up because I did see a lot when after my boss told me about it, I looked it up on TikTok. There are a million brands of protein shakes you can try. I think I'm going to buy some that have a more sweeter taste. Like the brand I buy, they in general are not that sweet. Premier, I forgot the name of it. Because even when I buy the chocolate one, it's not that sweet. And sometimes you kind of have to just gulp you down real fast. So I'm going to go buy maybe like another brand and maybe try like cookies and cream or vanilla. Just something that has a more sweet base. Also, if I am going to use Premier, I am going to go back and buy my regular caramel macchiato because it's only 5 more calories extra. My cat losing her mind, yeah. So, because at least I know my caramel macchiato is a little sweeter than this. And that Oatly, I don't like it. It don't taste like oats, but it definitely tastes like non-dairy, if that makes sense. So, I don't know about that. We're going to try it again. I'm going to go to the store later on today and try it again. And really, they better hope I'm going to put on clothes on right now and go try it again. Because I like my coffee a certain sweetness, but not too sweet. So it's not bad, don't get me wrong, but it is a new taste. Like, you have to be acquired taste to taste it this way. And I think it's just because I use Premier, and Premier is already just not that sweet. If you've ever drunk Premier, you know in general it's not a sweet protein shake. So I'm going to see. I must try it another way, and we're going to see before we rate it. Okay, y'all. So I ordered me a new little small tripod so that I can be able to do on my phone and my camera and take it into public without feeling like I'm about to get arrested or beat somebody. And this position could fit in a lot of my purses. So, and then I got this charger thing because, baby, if you don't know nothing else, this Sony camera, it's gonna die. So it can charge 3 batteries at a time, and that way I can have multiple backups because y'all know how sometimes this is the brand. And it was compatible with the Sony, and it is a X battery or something like that, which makes it compatible. So if you don't want to go and buy new Sony batteries, this is a great alternative. It looks kind of just like the battery, and they come in their own little boxes. Hold on, I shouldn't say tripod, but it's okay. Yeah, and they come in their own little cases, and yeah, they're compatible. My little cases, so when they come out of here, I can put them in here and then put them in my purse. That way they're protected. I'm about to see, do they need charging right now? So I can know how to move forward. I also still have my other charger that I use for my actual camera. But yeah, let's see how it works. Okay, the new tripod is so stinking cute. I did not get the one with the automatic, like, Bluetooth and all that because it was like 100 some bucks. And I think this one was what, maybe 19, maybe less than that. It has full rotation where it can spin. It does come with the phone clip too, so you can put your phone on in case you're doing something, and or you can put your camera. I also like that it does extend. Hold on, let's see. Can I get it extended while holding it? Okay, wait. So it does extend a little and opens up, so I can still sit it on the table, like if I'm at brunch or something. So I think that's very size appropriate because, like I said, you're not gonna be sitting up that high, and it's very cute, compact. Like I said, I was looking for something that could possibly fit in my purse. When I am trying to move on the go with the camera. I like it so far. This is the brand. It's off Amazon. And like I said, I have a big one that stands tall to the floor when I need to do major content or something. But this is definitely good for portable sizing. And for us who want to go out and do content but also be kind of nervous. Like starting out, we're nervous and stuff. Because, you know, when you're a beginner content creator, you do be nervous. Even though you ain't going to be nervous when that bag start hitting. You know, you're going to be looking at people like, yeah, you need to get on this train. But until then, you know, I be nervous with that big old stick. Like, I do. I be like, okay, I don't want to travel with it. I don't want to, like, I was nervous when I had travel with it when I went to the airports 2 or 3 times, and it still was okay. And for the batteries, when you get them, They do need charging. So when they're on red, that means they're dead. And then they turn green when they're ready. So when if you do go with this brand, you will have to charge them up. That is the brand for those. But yeah. Oh, and my iced coffee. Y'all, this was great. It did make me feel full. So I do like the actual protein idea, shake idea, because I feel full. Like usually around this time, I'm like, okay, I'm a little hungry, or my head start hurting because I need to eat. However, this was great. So yeah, here's my little updates for today. Okay, and this is with the update. This, y'all, hold on, I'm still playing with it, trying to make it centered. But this little tripod is so perfect. Like I said, it's easy to reach. Even if I don't extend it, it's like right here. If I extend it, I still can take you guys back. I still could bend the camera back and forth. So yeah, I will drop the link in my bio or in my description. But yeah, this is real cute. I like it. It's very compact, very, very compact. And that's what I was looking for, because I'm gonna show y'all a comparison when my husband get home, because my other one is in my husband's truck. I'm gonna show you the comparison of how I can't fit it in a purse, can't fit it in a bubble, like how big it is, but how sturdy and good it is too for when I am trying to place it. Oh, I want to see. Let me see how I look when I place it on the table. Don't mind my bed. I didn't make my bed this morning. Oh yeah, that is perfect. It's sturdy. Oh, okay. So yeah, we still in the game. Like I said, it's just shorter, smaller, more compact, where you do not have to be holding a huge thing. Like some of us who do like to go to pretty bars or go to just places, going around the store. You know how many people look at me crazy and I be having that big old stick in my hand like, what's she about to do? Like nothing. I'm just about to record content, y'all. I promise, nothing major. But so yeah, I like it. I'll be back though.
Y'all, I finally finished cleaning up my couch. Y'all remember all them clothes over there? Yeah. Finally done. And I've been watching TV and doing prints. And
y'all need to go watch Call Her King. I watch it on Amazon Prime. I have Prime. But y'all, it was so good. And I finally cleaned these kids' bathroom, because I be telling them to clean up. They do, but they don't do. Damn, you know, kids don't do the cleaning. You be wrong. Baby, I came in here, it was just stuff all around that toilet. Oh, they weren't getting the creases. And so I just came in here. I pick up their mats too. I swear they mats figured to go in the washer, because I don't know what they did, but they stink. They smell like they put a bunch of water on and like it did mildew or something. I'm not cleaning that. That's her room. I did straighten up baby boy's room while he was at school, made his bed, cleaned all his clothes up, and I gotta wash those little clothes for him. But yeah, and I, of course, I always keep my kitchen clean, so I swept and everything. I don't think I have left to do is actually mop, but I was waiting because I knew hubby was gonna do some yard work and be back and forth. I did not clean my room today. I didn't even make my bed, but I did clean my bathroom up. So I'm proud, because y'all know earlier today, maybe it was, you know, to clean my windows for y'all who kept talking about my little windows. Yeah. So, but I have been working. I've been working at work. I've been cleaning up and I've been doing my prints, because this lady have like 100 plus prints I have to do. So, I've been working, y'all. I ain't just been doing that. Y'all, it look like it's about to pour down out here in Denny. You can't eat. Oh, it don't look dark on the camera. I guess we had a camera made. But y'all, yeah, the wind blowing. It's about to pull down. I hope I get my food and come on back home before it pull down. Because guess who don't want to be caught in the rain? Me. Or the storm? Me. So yeah. So I'll be back. I think we're eating sushi tonight. So yeah. I'm going to probably get my spicy edamame made and my sushi. And we'll be back later on for dinner.
We're about to get some sushi. Sushi. Is it Tuesday or Wednesday? Oh, Wednesday. Sushi Tuesday. Instead of Taco Tuesday. This is our favorite spot in Denny, y'all.
Ain't there a bean in there?
I got to get a video.
Stop stuffing
your mouth. But me and JoJo got Sunset Shrimp. You know that little sushi. I mean, Sunset Sushi. And we're going to
fried rice. Ooh, y'all so good.
She mad I got a bomb. that type of she's trying a scratch pad. She don't know what it is yet. She like, what the hell is that? It's a scratch pad, mama. She like, what is this? Let me see. Yeah. She probably gonna tear it up later. She don't know what it is yet. Good morning. Happy Wednesday. I'm up getting the kids ready. I just made my bed because I like to get up and start my day. And I'm lighting candles all around because that's what I love to do. My kids say every morning, my mom gonna get up and light them candles. I'm gonna light them candles because I'm gonna light them candles. But y'all, it is extremely cold in the house because we had the AC on, but it's colder. Y'all, I went outside, well, to the back door. Y'all, it is freezing outside. And the wind blowing. Look at my tree. Like, I don't know if you see them trees back there. You can't see them, how I can see them. Y'all, it's freezing out there. And the wind blowing hard as hell. I thought it was raining when I woke up. Like, when I heard it, I thought it was raining. Nope. And it's crazy because on the camera, you can barely see the trees move. Like, it like it's moving slow. But when you're looking at it in person, they like super flowing. But yeah, so I made sure the kids, I told them, make sure they put on some warm clothes because, baby, it's cold. I don't know what's going on, but it's cold. But yeah. And y'all, I'm still trying to think about my decorations. Like, I love my wall letter, but I'm still trying to figure decorations out. Like, I know I need something else in here. I know I'm going to give me some more pillows to add. And my throw blanket, I kind of just throw it over the couch just for to make it look nice. But I don't know. I'm still debating. Go put your shirt on. Oh, but see, I was trying to see, can y'all hear it? So you can hear it through the house. That's how cold it is. I mean, that's how hard the wind blowing, not how cold it is. Oh, am I still zooming? Oh no, you can't hear it like I thought. But yeah, it's definitely cold. It will be this kind of weather when I gotta get up and go to court today. In-person court. Usually other courts virtual, but this is gonna be a final for one of my sets of family, so. Why I gotta be cold now? So yeah, but happy Wednesday. I'm gonna drop them off, come back home, get myself together, and yeah, we'll be back. Hey y'all, I'm back. Y'all, I just really brought y'all back so we could talk. Cause y'all, I hate looking for houses. So we were gonna buy a house this year. Honestly, it was on our to-do list. It was just one of our goals for 2024. However, being that a lot has happened since the beginning of 2024 and it's only February, I think for me, for my safety net, for my comfort, I wanna push it off for about another year. That just honestly give us time to do what we need to do and really just give us time to see what we really want to do. Because at this point, do we really want to stay in an urban area? Do we want to find some country land? Do we want to build? You know, it's a lot of choices, and I honestly just don't want to feel rushed at all about nothing. You know what I'm saying? So we're going to look at a house today. Actually, we're going to look at a townhouse because the realtor, she does
She do rentals and she do if you want to buy. So she told us she could still help us find a new rental if we want to move. Because honestly, I told her I want to find something more affordable because I feel like I'm spending all our money going into, you know, rental situations and we still just don't really care for the home. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like we rushed. I don't say we rushed, but it was a great opportunity that was handed to us when we got this house. And like I said, we were going to be here almost going on 2 years. But it's just, it's not spacious, y'all. Y'all know I hate tiny closets. I hate for my closet to feel bundled up. Everything, like, my closet is low. The tub, it sucks. It's not even one of the pretty tubs with the, you know, it sucks, y'all. So, I'm like, what the, you know. So, and it's just no space. Like, yeah, I have this little extra office, but it's kind of where my dogs is. Like, that, and that's one thing we couldn't compromise on. Like, my husband don't want to compromise on giving up the dogs, and I don't want to compromise on finding a space where they can be. So at this point, we really need like a 4 or 5 bedroom, and I'm just being realistically, or spaces, or a 4 bedroom with one of the offices. But however, we did actually find this townhouse that's by us, and it's honestly, it's spacious. We're gonna go view it today. It's spacious, but it's also, like I told him, like, I don't mind living in town. Like, he know I always want to live condo townhouse. Like, when I first moved to Texas, that's what I stayed in, a townhouse. I loved it. We also didn't have no dogs. We had my little bitty dog, but she don't count because her little cage didn't count. But we didn't have no actual dog. You know, we didn't have no big animals. So, you know, it was fine. But I'm just looking at the picture, and I can't wait. Y'all, this master room looks so freaking big. I can't wait to go see it. But I'm also thinking to myself, I don't see no tub. I don't see no tub. And I'm like, what? You know, y'all know I gotta have my tub. But on the pictures, the walk-in closet looks 3 times huger than what we have in this little corner over here, y'all. Because when I say it's a corner, there isn't a tub. Nope. It's a not, now I do like the counter space. It's still double sink, but it's longer, way more space, and it has a lot more drawers. Like, it's literally three rows of 6 drawers, and your regular pull out thing and a pull out. So that there alone is already way more space. Y'all be seeing when I be in there, way more counter space than what we have, and it's a big, huge, gorgeous mirror, but it's only a shower. Which could be a blessing because all I had to do was just clean the shower. But it's only a shower. Y'all know I love my tubs. Like, I love to soak. So, I don't know, y'all. I'm trying to figure it out. I'm trying to feel it out because I'm also just trying to see. Because now that I'm looking at some of the pictures, like, yeah, it looks spacious. The kids' rooms look spacious. Their closets look bigger. But I'm not going to have my study. So, if you know my house, my study is also where all of my business supplies is. Like, my crafting business. That's where my big machines are. It's where everything is. So, I'm like, if I put that in there, you know. See, the kids' bathroom, they got double sinks and they have a tub. It's their tub is by their toilet. They have a tub, but upstairs doesn't have a tub. Our room. And it come with washer and dryer, and it come with auto appliances. And don't get me wrong, I have my own washer and dryer, but I'm like, dang, it's already one in here provided for us. Like, that's a good thing. You know, that's a lifesaver. Because by the time we moved to our real house, I was going to sell this washer and dryer anyway and get new appliances. So, I don't know. I have to see it in person. And that's what we're trying to go do today. Because I don't know, y'all. I'm real iffy because I don't want to leave where I am to kind of have not like bigger space. It's like I'm getting bigger space in some areas, but also taking away space in some areas. Like, I won't have this study, meaning I got to find somewhere to put all my crafting stuff. How am I going to run my t-shirt business? How am I going to run my crafting business with nowhere to put my stuff? You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I don't know, y'all. I'm stressed out. I'm not saying it's the only thing for now, but it's definitely one of the ones we're looking at right now. And like I told him, what about a backyard for the dogs? Like, that means, yes, we pick up the poop now, but you don't do it every day. Over here, you're going to be having to do it every day. Like, what you going to do? Because I don't deal with them dogs. They're not my dogs. I don't deal with them, and he know that. So, what you going to do? don't know, but I'm just coming to rent, y'all, because I'm just so tired of, honestly, I'm tired of paying rent. Damn, find me a $1,400 house. But then I know it's probably going to be in the area I just don't want to stay in. You know what I'm saying? Or even the areas we don't want to stay in, I don't think they exist no more. So, yes, mortgage is cheaper because you will be, you know, buying mortgage. But at the same time, when the mortgage ain't just there right now, you know, what do? You know, when you don't have a choice right now, what do you do? So, I don't know, y'all. I'm just for that. Cry. I'm back again. So, thank God my court was canceled. I'm glad because I did not feel like driving to Fort Worth. However, the showing for the house had to be rescheduled to tomorrow morning. Kind of bummed about that because I wanted to see. But, and then I'm also bummed because my car people just called me and they're going to, I'm thankful. I'm take that back because I'm not going to complain. I'm thankful that basically I am getting my engine fixed under factory warranty and it's all great, you know. However, they did just text me and tell me that my window issue can't be covered by my extended warranty because my extended warranty only comes into effect once the factory warranty expires, and my factory warranty is nowhere near expired, and the things that's wrong aren't covered by the warranty due to the fact that I had accident repairs performed on the vehicle, I guess, whoever had it before me. And they got me a quote and it's like $1,400. And I'm like, fuck. Sorry for the language. Because I'm like, I don't want to drop $1,400. I mean, am I thankful to drop $1,400 over $9,000 plus for engine work? Sure. But am I, you know, excited about dropping this? No. So now I'm about to just call my dad and let him know what they said, and see can he fix it for free. Well, you know, I get the parts, cool, but I don't know. But I don't know, it's always something, and I just feel like I'm already having a rough time in general. And I'll be back because I'm about to cry. Honestly, I ain't gonna lie. And I'm emotional. And I'm just, it's not just my car. It's a whole bunch of other factors. And so, I'll be back. I did want to update y'all, though. But we'll see. So, yeah. Y'all, I got my baby back. And look what's up. I had to double take because I'm going to look like my goddamn tent was gone. Hold on. Y'all, look what I got back. My baby. Y'all, I missed my fucking car. I don't care what nobody say. Now, I am mad, but I'm grateful because baby, my daddy just went slap off on me. I was on the phone with him telling him about what all they sent me, basically telling me my engine work was done, but regarding my window. So, let me tell you how they bamboozled me, y'all, which I'm still going to call my extended warranty people and see if that's really what it means. And then I'm just going to take it to a regular mechanic because they take licensed mechanics too, because I think Volkswagen just trying to get some money because they mad because they had to pay for all my shit. It was covered by warranty. But, so, they tried to say they can't send in a claim to my extended warranty people because my extended warranty don't kick in until my warranty expires. My warranty don't expire till 2025 or till I reach 65,000 miles. I'm near neither. I'm nowhere near 65,000 miles, and I'm nowhere near 2025 of April. Okay, so we ain't even made it to April of 2024. So I knew off top that was gonna be, I wasn't gonna be able to do that. So that upsetted me because I'm like, dang, I really wanted this window covered by my warranty. You know, I wanted to get it fixed. However, I'm glad they fixed the major issue. And like I told y'all on my other blogs, I'm actually glad it happened how it happened, because if I hadn't paid to get that other stuff done and just drove home, blah, 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 I wouldn't have even known I needed engine work or I needed starter plugs, cylinders, whatever they fixed. You know what I'm saying? So I was grateful for that. But I'm even more grateful that they was trying to charge me $1,400 to fix whatever going on my window. My daddy told me absolutely not. He said, didn't they do a diagnostic? I said, yeah. He said, so haven't they told you what's wrong with the window? Like, meaning what need fixed? You know what I mean, y'all? I ain't got no car sense. I just know how to drive the motherfucker, put gas in it, and get the oil change. You know, I know the basics. I don't know nothing about all the pieces to the pieces, you know? So I'm like, yeah, daddy. Yeah, he sent me an email about what's wrong with it. He said, okay, so go pick your car up. He said, go take them people they loan or go pick your car up. I said, but what about the window? You got $1,400? Are you finna send me $1,400? He was like, you don't need $1,400. He done already told you the issue. Now you can just call around to McKinney and see who gonna fix this. And she was like, I guarantee you it's way cheaper. He said, matter of fact, tell me what's wrong. So I go to explain. He said, for your driver window? He's like, for your window? I said, yeah. He said, baby, that part alone less than $100. I said, well, I don't know. You know, Dad, I don't know. I'm just going by what they tell me. I can email you over the breakdown. You want that? You know, I don't know what to tell you at this point. What do you want me to do? He said, girl, he said, go get your car. He said, go get your M&F car, matter of fact. But I'm going to say, he said, go get your car. And he said, and he said, send me the make and model of your car and your everything. And he's like, I'm going to get on online and order the part. And I'm like, so that mean you coming out here to fix my car? Or what? I mean, because I be hiding my camera, y'all, from these policemen. Because I feel like, honestly, driving with a camera up is just like driving with a phone, meaning I'm not paying attention or something. You know what I'm saying? I feel like it's the same thing. So I lower my camera when I get near police. Do anybody else do that? I don't know if y'all do it, y'all don't. But I do it because I'm like, I don't want you to think I'm not paying attention to the road, because even though I'm looking straight, meaning I am paying attention, like I'm looking straight out the window. However, if you see me holding the camera or see me glance or something, I don't want you to think that I'm not paying attention when I am. Do that make sense? See, like, look, he looking now because I got the thing. Like, it's just like I be trying to see, like, do that make sense? I think it do, but I don't know, y'all. So I'm just having to figure it out. But I'm excited to have my baby back because, one, that other truck was too much gas. And, two, it just feel different when you driving your own stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, even though I have insurance, they had my insurance on file. They was like, so if I wrecked, it was covered. I was going to be protected. But it's just different when you drive. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, I don't want to sound bad, okay? Because I'm not saying I don't drive with caution now, because I do. But I'm saying you be driving with extra caution. Like, you be scared to goddamn move. Always, you know what I'm saying? When you went, oh, goddamn, they didn't fix my shit. My shit, hold on now. It took off. And, but you get what I'm saying? I don't know if anybody else felt like that. Like, when you're driving rentals and loaners and other people's cars, you be just feel like it's a lot of anxiety. For me, it's a lot of anxiety. So, baby, I'm just glad to have my baby back, because, baby, I know how to whip that thing, roll that thing. I told y'all I call her stankin' language. She ain't no stankin' language. But I'm just glad to have my baby back, y'all. I'm finna go. I know I've been on here talking about 2 minutes. I ain't gonna lie. I'm sorry, but I'm just excited, y'all. Because I am so glad to have my car back. Because, baby, yo. And overall, I guess I'll say I spent at the dealership about, what, $500? Because the first time they got it was $208. And this time today, they discounted my diagnosis today, because baby, who I'm showing my natural black surely is. So they discounted it, because remember the first time I told y'all that was like $900 to do an extra diagnosis. They only charged me $370. So hey, I'll take it. Like my daddy said, take your wins, be blessed, be thankful, and go on about your business. He was like, at the end of the day, yeah, you spent what, $500, but at least you know what's wrong with your car, and at least you got your motor work done for free. So I will take it. Thank you, Jesus. I will take it. So I'm not complaining, but you know, I could still use my 370. That especially around the time daycare do. You know, it's the first for the be getting ring for the, you know what I'm saying? But I'll take it, Lord. I'm thankful. So yeah, I'll be back. That's my little rant for the day, y'all.
Finishing up my order. Look at this.
Okay, y'all. I'm tired. Baby, we got Domino's tonight. I just got the garlic knots, but I like the marinara cheese dip they have. You add extra. I think Hubby had got some pizza and wings.
Why you got me on this?
Because I know you be wanting to be on there like you're playing.
You want me on your stuff. You know you need a star on your channel. That's what you know.
I am the star, baby. What do you mean?
Baby, listen here. You put me on there and then include me in the description. Watch your video.
Include you what? You ain't got no page.
You ain't got just say JD. Fuck, all this JD on there? Oh, hell yeah.
He swear he famous.
Views gonna go up. Everybody know JD.
Follow my husband.
One and only, you already know.
You ain't got no YouTube, so what's your shout out?
Follow me on Instagram, PoloMan11. I'm a great content creator. I do it all.
Boy,
you know what I'm saying?
You don't even post.
I just don't post because I don't need to post. You know
do you know what content creator is then?
Why is
you have to post in order to be a content creator.
I motivated her to be this YouTube person, you know, so if it wasn't for me, she wouldn't even be blogging for y'all.
Boy,
you know,
please.
She wouldn't be doing none of this for y'all.
Stop the cap. This technically my second channel, first off. I had a channel when we first moved to Frisco, and then my email got hacked. And everything else that came with it, baby. So, stop the cap.
And who told you to go back and chase it?
Myself.
Oh, come on. You gonna do me like that?
Mr. Famous.
Oh, my. She gonna do me like that when I'm the one to... Yeah.
Anyway, y'all, we eating dinner and watch TV. I'm trying to wait on Sisters while he's starting his little Tubi movie. Baby, it's getting cut off at 8 o'clock because Sisters is coming on this TV because I got to see it.
Oh, okay.
Y'all, he get off. Anyway, y'all, but that's it for tonight. I'll be back tomorrow. See y'all later. Happy Thursday. Hey y'all, welcome back to Ebony Maria. I'm Elb. Thank y'all so much for subscribing and joining our circle. Y'all, waiting on the kids to get ready. I have gotten up, got myself together. I'm putting on a jumpsuit. Thought you could see the pants, you can't. But the hoodie is in there. I'm just waiting because I do got my heat going and I'm not trying to fall out. But baby, why is this Dallas weather? It plays so much down here. I just can't. We was in the 80s and 90s for about 2 weeks straight, right? Yesterday, it was about 55 at the highest, all the way from 30 to 55. Early in the morning, 30, the highest got 55. Why I check my weather today? It's talking about snow flurries. What? And then you're going to be talking about 90 degrees again Saturday. Like, baby, we going to... Forever be with the flu, forever be with COVID and all these crackers, baby. The weather can't get right. Like, look at that. I already sound like I'm getting ready to get sick. Because, baby, what? We doing what? So, now my kids and they're getting ready. And I'm making sure they bundle up, putting on good amount of clothes, long sleeves, socks, coats and shit. Because, especially my son, because y'all, them schools be trifling. They'll still let them have recess and shit. Like, baby, take my son in the building. Then y'all get the fucking notification say it's flurries. They don't even know how recess. Y'all better put on some movies and let them play around the classroom. Now, my daughter, I ain't worried about her because they don't even have portables at her school. These fancy new schools, baby, down here, they don't even have portables. So all they do is walk around the building. And then the most they see outside is when they come into school and fit to go home from school. That's it. So, but I still make sure she be having on a coat, you know, socks and stuff too. But, baby, I'm just over it. But I'm about to go drop them off. Then I have to run to Walmart because I need a few things. And I keep forgetting, honestly. And I'm going to do that after I drop them off to just waste time. Because I go meet with this first lady for this house at 9. We're going to start at 9. And then she got to show me another one. It was supposed to be 3. But somebody rented the other one out yesterday. And I'm like... And it was really one of the ones we wanted. Now, don't get me wrong. I wasn't probably going to like the inside as much. Because it wasn't as... It wasn't as updated as the other ones, but it had a backyard and it had a fence. And it was a townhouse, meaning my dogs could have still just went straight outside. And I'm not against the other ones because, I mean, they got a dog park. But I am against it when I got to be the one to take them out. Because what? Because that's ghetto. Because if I can't just let them run to the backyard, I don't like that. You in brush your teeth? Go on in there with your sister. Go brush your teeth.
Fine,
what you looking for?
Socks, I can't.
It's socks in your drawer. That's how I know you ain't looking. Look in your underwear drawer. It's rolled up socks in there from when I done washed your clothes all this week. You ain't looking. Yesterday. Keys don't look for nothing. You went in the same drawer this morning, got underwear to put on. New, fresh underwear. But you didn't see all them rolled up socks. Oh, okay. Yeah, because you don't look for nothing. You just walking around the house pouting because you don't want to go to school. You going. You fucking going. But yeah, so I'm gonna see, and I don't know. We're gonna do what we do, and at this point, Like the third option though, because it does have a study, and if y'all know, I like to have a study because that's typically where I set my stuff up. We already decided the dog's going under the garage, cold or hot. We're gonna get a fan, heat up, because I'm just sick of it. I'm sick of them being in my house. Piper by on her way out the motherfucker though too, cause she bad as shit. Excuse the language. Shouldn't be no kids on her, but yes, she bad. So, I'ma see. But I'm thinking, I really like the first one. I love because it's newer. It's kind of like my same thing, the marble granite table countertops, the new appliance, all that. The third one, I can't remember if it was the same way, but just had a study. So it was a little more. But the first one was just, I think, right at 2000. The one we wanted with the backyard was 1950. But, I mean, somebody rented it. So I'm like, dang. But, yeah, so we'll see. I'm about to get it finished. Go ahead and finish getting him ready. Get his hair brushed, face oil, grease. Make sure. I'll be back, y'all. Yeah. Okay, y'all. I dropped the kids off. I came to the gas station to get some gas because, baby, we were on low fuel, okay? And I'm gonna go to Walmart because I'm out of mouthwash and just some small things I need around the house. So the house that I am going to see first is only 8 minutes from this Walmart, and I don't have to be there till 9. So I'm gonna go ahead and run at Walmart to spare a couple of minutes, so I won't just be sitting there for like a whole hour, you know? But I did give me a little small coffee. It wasn't the protein shake this morning because I wasn't. Oh, and that's what I'm gonna look in here and see too. I want some different proteins because that caramel one is good, but also that I told y'all that brand I buy is not really sweet enough to mix with coffee. And especially maybe if you buy like light coffee, yes. But see, I buy dark roast coffee because that's the type of coffee I like. So, and it's raining, y'all. So I'm mad because it said flurries. It really didn't say rain, and I got on my Uggs. So I'm super pissed because y'all know Uggs stain easy. So I'm like, what the freak? Dang it! I was supposed to get my umbrella out the trunk while I was while I was under the carport of the gas station. However, now I'm not under the carport. They don't have a carport thing here at Walmart, so I'm trying to find a park. But yeah, other than that, today after I see these houses, I'm gonna go home. I have a little few things to work on for work. I have virtual court at 2. And baby, honestly, I tell my husband I'm gonna be applying for me just a part-time job. I would rather work a part-time job that's online only. But if I can find something that's in store like Kroger or something too, I may just do that because Kroger pay weekly. So I might just do that. Okay, this is the closest I'm gonna get. So let's just park right here. But yeah, so I'll be back. I may bring y'all to Walmart with me. I may not. I don't know. It depends because I don't have my regular purse. I have a rest of my purse. So, and I don't want my camera messed up in this rain. So we'll see. It depends on how I can get this It really depends on if I can get this watch. Oh, he moved good. I'm gonna go up because I want to be close to the grocery door. I can't depend if I can get my umbrella out the trunk, y'all. So okay, I'll be back, y'all. Okay, y'all, I made it back to the car. It's raining even harder than what it was when I went in, but I made it back to the car. Okay, so I ended up not bringing y'all to Walmart, sorry. But I ended up getting me some new mason jars, the little 8 ounce, because I couldn't remember where my other ones went, and maybe when I moved I threw them away, they walked away, I don't know. Whatever the case is, I got some new ones so I could start back juicing, because I really did enjoy juicing when I first started my weight loss journey the first time. It helped me out tremendously. So now that I am on a weight loss journey and actually losing weight, I figured why not. So I just got me some pineapples and cucumbers. I love juicing cucumbers. It's full of water. It's, it keep you so hydrated. And I heard pineapples has a lot of good benefits for juicing, which I used to juice them sometimes, but I used to just add it to it. Like when I juice like my hard vegetables, like beets and stuff that wasn't really sweet, I added pineapple for the sweetness. But I do like pineapple and cucumber together. It's so good. If you haven't juiced it, try it. So I got me some pineapples. They were on sale for $1. And the cucumbers, of course, were like 70 something cent a piece. And I did get my mouthwash, and so now for my protein coffee. Yeah, I know I was on the hunt for another one. I got the brand that everybody was recommending on TikTok, which is Atkins. I got that, and I did get cafe caramel, so maybe it'd be a little sweeter. So with Atkins brand, it is 15 grams of protein, 3 grams of net carbs, 1 gram of sugar, and 3 grams of fiber. Oh, this say made with real coffee. As much caffeine as a cup of coffee. Oh, wait a minute. So maybe I don't need to add this with coffee. Maybe I just need to pour this over ice and drink it. Okay. I don't think I may buy these again because these are higher in calorie than my other ones. I have to check when I get home. I'm going to do and see. Which I'm not calorie watching. Don't get me wrong. So that doesn't really bother me that it is more. But I do want to watch my calories if I am trying to lose weight. You know, it makes sense. But, I mean, at this point, you take what you can get. I'm cutting back on sugar. I'm cutting back on sweets, all that. So, at least I'm serving on the sugar size. I mean, I'm saving on the sugar size, okay? But this one is 160 calories. 9 grams of fat. 2% cholesterol. 250 milligrams of sodium. 6 grams of total carbohydrate. Only 1 gram of sugar and no added sugars. So, I don't know. It may be the same. It is gluten-free. So, I don't know if I can add coffee with this. I didn't look at that part when I was... it does say caffeine in the... I don't know. I don't know. As much coffee as I drink, I don't think it's going to hurt my black ass. Okay? So, I don't think it probably will boost the energy, which... I could use that anyway, and it, I mean, you know, it's not gonna hurt. I drink so many cups of coffee a day anyway, I don't think it's really gonna hurt. But I have now, I can tell y'all, oh, that's another good thing I've been doing. I do got a small one. I have cut my coffee intake, y'all. And honestly, I've been finding myself so sleepy earlier in the day than I do since I cut my intake. Because y'all know, normally I used to drink about 4 or 5 cups of coffee throughout the day, especially throughout a work day. Now, after 5 o'clock, only time you'll catch me with some iced coffee or just a cup of coffee is if I'm craving it, like around Mother Nature time, or if I'm real stressed out, that's my go-to. I'm telling y'all, I'm really like an addict when it comes to coffee. Like, if I ever get put in a center for having addiction, it's literally going to be for coffee. Never think of drug, coffee. Coffee is my drug. Like, I no longer do that. I fix 1 cup a day now. So, kudos to me. I'm going to fix 2 today. Sorry. And that's only because I have this one while I'm out and about working. But when I go home, I'm definitely fixing my iced coffee with this one to see if it tastes better. Because I'm going to get this protein shake thing right. Okay? That's what I'm going to do. So, but yeah. I've only been doing 1 cup a day. Kudos to me. Pat myself on the back. Because... it's just been better. You know, I ain't gonna lie, it's been better. So, I'm thankful for that. I'm changing my nails again. Not this week. I don't know, not today, not this week. But, I like the long, I do. I just can't get with square or coffee. It's something about it. I just love my oval round. So, if I do change, I may make them stiletto. And maybe see how that goes. And then if I don't make a stiletto, I'm definitely going back to my little pointed round shape I always wear. Yeah. Because that's what I like, y'all. So, but okay. I'm about to head to this house so we can see this first house. And then I'll keep y'all updated. I don't know if I'm not going to put it on here because I don't know if it's one I'm going to get or not. If I get something new, when we sign the lease, now that I'll come in and show y'all before and after. But I don't know, because right now we still just on the mix or on the hunt for, we don't know if we want to stay, go to another house or just do another townhouse, but I don't know, we'll see. So, okay, I'll be back. Y'all, I have made it back home. The houses, all three she showed me today were townhouses, so they were all okay. I take it back. The first two were okay. That first one, gorgeous. When I say gorgeous, gorgeous, y'all. But it has a few... I'm going to have to prop y'all like this because I forgot this little thing. It has a few cons. Like, not bad cons, but like I'm trying to get my husband to realize, every option we seen, first off, the first one, it's only going to save us, what, $200? That's it. The second one only gonna save us $95. And the third one saves about $450. So that's a good plus, because then that could be used definitely towards like groceries and stuff. You know, it's good. But the third one, the one that saved us the $450, it wasn't giving, honey. It was trash. And I feel like we're gonna be, it wasn't trash, but it wasn't what we needed. Like, it had the gated backyard, it had the bonus study room, but it was all carpet upstairs. It was real older, let's just say that. And for 2024, I'm not trying to be, you know. So yeah, it was that. And the first one, y'all, where my phone? I left my phone. Gorgeous, loves it. My husband wanted to put out the application today, but it has cons for me. And like, I'm trying to tell him, you don't work from home, you don't really deal with these dogs until after hours. It has no gated backyard, meaning every day I'm gonna be having to try to put them on a leash to let them use the restroom. There's no dog park. Even if it is a dog park, we're talking about some dogs who held their shit in peace overnight and throughout the day. So by the time I get them on a leash, get them out the garage, get them out, they're gonna be trying to go wherever they see fit. It's not gonna be no enjoyment at all for them. Like, they literally are gonna be just miserable, because you don't have no backyard, you don't have no dog, you're never gonna stretch your legs, you're never gonna be able to run around. Even when he take y'all for a walk, you can't run around like you can in the backyard. So you're gonna just be like, for what? Then two, it has no study. It has no extra room. It's not a 4-bedroom. So that's more pressure on me, because then that means my entire study that's in there, my entire session of my t-shirt business, I have nowhere to put that. I got to get out this hoodie out, because I left the heat on, and yeah, it's a little toasty in here now. I have nowhere to put that. And when I say nowhere, I'm not leaving it downstairs to have my downstairs area cluttered or whatever. You know, that's not what I like. However, when I say the master bedroom was gorgeous, closet big like my old house. Girl, what else can I say? Bathroom super long, double sink still, but so much space in between. Big pretty mirrors. And when I say the drawers, we had about, literally in the middle, it was about 6 to 8 drawers by itself before you even pull out the long drawers or the two bottom drawers, the two cabinets. So you still had all that. Gorgeous. Separate bathroom for the toilet. Like, it's not my toilet out right here. It has a whole door area. Y'all, gorgeous. And when I say gorgeous, gorgeous. Gorgeous. And then all the stuff in the kitchen is still kind of like my house now, with the gray seal, the gray cabinets and the new appliance. They had the refrigerator with the ice maker. So it was gorgeous. But the only cons is it has no backyard for the dogs. I have nowhere to put my t-shirts though. Second house, similar to the first house, still updated appliance, has the bonus room, has the backyard. However, one thing that rubbed me out of the neighbor rubbed me. First of all, while in the middle of showing his house, he come banging on the door. Me and the realtor looking at each other like, you showing somebody else the house? Or you like you know, like, what? So he's like, oh no, I was just trying to see what's going on. Red flag number one, you nosy. You nosy as fuck. Why are you trying to see what's going on when it's like a whole realtor? Oh, I'm a realtor too. I don't give a fuck. Oh, well, I was just trying to see what was going on, because the landlord let me keep my, keep some stuff in the garage, which, don't forget, it was some stuff in the garage. And however, I didn't like how nasty they were. Like, I already tell y'all was going to be a problem for me. Y'all were nasty. They had a whole bunch of tubs and stuff piled up at the front door, and how the front door is, we both walk up and then my door this way, this door that way. A whole bunch of tubs that say like Christmas stuff. No, baby, that's what you got an attic for. Put that shit up. That's not gonna work for me. That's gonna bother me. Every day I walk out, that's gonna bother me. So I'm like, no to that already. Two, you know, you too nosy for me. I don't like no real nosy neighbor. Like, to this day, I've been here 2 years, and I speak to my one neighbor through the backyard only. Like, we'll talk through the fence, or he'll throw his head, you know, he'll tell us when we barbecue, it smell good. And my lady on the other side, she a little old white racist bitch. So I don't even encounter with her. Like,
We still like line her side of the grass up just for the hell of being nice, but the bitch don't even speak. Like, my kid waited her one day and she didn't even speak. And then from that day, my hood told her, don't speak to that bitch no more. Just like that. Like, just like that. Because this is what you want to do in 24, please. And yeah, the neighbors are not nosy. They mind their business, we mind our business. But you over here, I feel like you're going to be nosy. I feel like you're gonna be trying to watch my house. I feel like you're gonna be calling the police. Like, I ain't got nothing to call police on, but I just feel like you look like the type of neighbor if I play my music too loud, which I don't even do that. But still, I don't know. Sometimes nosy neighbors is a blessing, sometimes they a curse. Like, you just a curse, and I feel like it'd be a curse with him. But the backyard, hold on, let me get my phone because I'm trying to watch the videos because I recorded it. So, y'all, this is what, look at it. Hold on, let me show y'all. Like, this outside the front porch. Like, why is all that? The lights were off on this one because, of course, they had just moved out. So, I'm trying to see what was some more pros. Oh, the second pros was it's in the same school district for my kids now. So, we stay, literally, I passed my house coming from the other house, passed my house on the back street to get to it. Like, that was literally one of the cons. One of the pros. They'll be in the same district. The other pros, I like that it had the bathroom downstairs. The washroom is still right now. I don't like that washroom downstairs because then you got to haul all that. Babe, my washroom already right here next door to my room now, and it takes me forever. You know what I'm saying? So, because I couldn't see me. Sorry, I didn't know it was that dark. And I didn't like that the second house don't have an ice maker. Like, it has that on top of each other refrigerator. Like, it's not the one like I had the same. You know, it's still stainless steel. It had a good pantry. It did have a lot of closets and storage. I did like that. It's not a flat top stove. I didn't really like that. It's like the regular burners. It still had a nice area. It still had area you could put bar stools. It had area you could put dining room table and have a living room set. So, it was still had, you know, it had a lot of pros. I thought I could speed this up. But, oh, yeah. So, it had a lot of pros. And the garage was a single garage, but it still had room where I could definitely have potential to put the dogs right there. The stairs were carpet. Dang it, y'all. Hold on. The stairs were carpet. I didn't kind of like that part because, oh, was the stairs carpet? No, not in the house. The stairs were sweepable, regular vinyl floor, the regular wooden floors. And the wooden floors was everywhere in this house. I did like that there was no carpet. I did like that it had a lot of storage. It had a lot of little areas. So, I don't know how you... Oh, right here. The bedroom, the master bedroom was a little smaller than the first one. Now, that first one, baby, that master bedroom, it was huge. And then we decreased to one sink, and my husband don't like that, instead of having double sink. However, I had the deep tub and the shower was in the tub. So, we didn't, you know, I liked the tub. That was a con for the first house. The first house had a huge shower, but it did not have a freaking tub. And I was like, I'm going to miss my tub. But, you know, the closets and the spacing for the kids was still okay. Like, they would still have a tub back. You know, it was usable. And then, like I said, it had the bonus room in the middle. So, I could potentially have somewhere to put all my stuff. All my business stuff. Because at this point, that's why I was telling him when we was talking. I was like, you're not thinking about the fact I have to find somewhere to put all this stuff. Like, you're just thinking about, oh, we leave the dogs in the cage. So, I get there, da-da-da, da-da-da, root-to-root. Whatever, get it, cool, get all that. But you saying that now, but you also not thinking about that your young dog pregnant, fit to have puppies. So you talking about leaving this dog on the garage and this and that, and this fit starting hot, cold. You ain't gonna stand up to your word for that, and they not coming in my house. They not. That first setup, they not. Ain't no room for them, ain't nowhere for them. I wish he had just said them hoes. I'm gonna be quite frank, honest. Sell them. Which I get is a man's best friend, them his babies. I get all that, but however, I don't care. Or I just don't care for him. Like, we can keep Ace. We can keep Ace. Cause this whole dog business, it ain't for me. And it's blowing me nuts at this point. Like, I don't know, y'all. I really wish, though. If we could get rid of them, we'll be honest, because then we won't need a damn backyard. My kids, they better ride them bike down, go outside, no way. So, I don't know, y'all. I'm torn, because I don't, at that point, like I told you, at that point, we can stay where they got a backyard. We just keep living here for however many years it takes us until we decide to buy whatever, whoop the whoop, because at this point, yeah, I just deal what I got and work with it, baby.
With this protein shake, y'all, it definitely kind of got like a coffee taste, but I could taste the caramel. It's good, y'all. I've been missing this up since I made it. It is so good. I'm gonna have, yeah, I like this one better than the other one.
Okay, y'all, I'm back. I finally finished doing my core and some work. Now I am actually trying to throw some food together. I had a taste for some smothered. I want to eat the smothered chicken or something. So I actually had some gizzards in the freezer. So I'm going to do smothered gizzards, rice and gravy, and corn. And I'll probably throw the kids some chicken tenders in the air fryer because they don't really eat gizzards. But they will eat the rice and gravy and the corn. And while I got this on, my rice is actually almost done. It ain't going to take me long to fry my gizzards. So while that's cooking down for a few more minutes, I'm letting it cook. Then I'm actually going to run to the store and get some gravy. I ain't got no gravy. And then I'm going to run while I'm out from coming from the store. Go and pick them up so they can, you know, get home from school, after school, and all that stuff. Because, baby, it's raining and all that. But I'm going to be taking me a shower. I'm looking for my, where my strainer? So I can strain my rice. And, baby, I'm going to take me a shower. And I'm going to be up under the bed, okay? Because this good little weather. Y'all, I know I'm crazy. My kids be, what? They probably put it on this side. Yeah, I'm like, what is the dang old strainer? And that's about it. I'm finna go run up here to this Dollar General that I have. Get that real quick. Throw this meat together, air fry them some, thing. Oh, I need to get a small thing of grease because I fried fish in my other look. My little fryer last, and I don't want my chicken where I fry my fish. So, what happened? So, I'm going to go ahead and get a small thing grease. I can just put on a soda fry me and his gizzards. And then, like I said, I'm going to throw that stuff in the air fryer. And, whew, that's going to be that, y'all. So, yeah. I'll be back. This is what I'm talking about. It's hailing. In the middle of nowhere, hail is falling. Like, can y'all hear it? You can't even hear, you can't see it, but you can hear it. It's hailing, y'all. It's definitely hailing. I fall for you every time I try to persist. You can get away. I'm chasing these fields and then every day. All I want to hear is an episode that we play.
think it needs me. I swear I'm trying to keep these feelings to myself. Now you're the one I'm thinking of. My higher ground, my rocket love. For gravity, I'd rather stay up here. We can get away from cheese, peach, fuel, so